Hey everybody, in this video I'm going to walk you through three simple steps on improving your cinematics for your video game montages. These are effects applied to the cinematics you have already shot, so if you don't have cinematics to use, I have over 100 cinematics you can use for Valorant. I'll put a download link in the description. They're free, all you have to do is type in zero, then hit enter. Some people are confused by that, but there's free cinematics there. If not, I have a tutorial already on how you can create your own smooth Valorant angles using a controller, kind of getting a smoother camera movement, and I'll link that down in the description as well. So if you hear the rain, it is raining where I am right now and it is hitting the window. Not sure if the camera picks that up. We're already in After Effects here and I already have my clip from Icebox. This is one of the ones I supply for free. My first step is going to be just slightly adjusting the camera scale, position, rotation. I combine all three of these into one step, and really the keys are here to be subtle, because we're going to make this camera a little more dynamic than just the camera movement in there. If your cinematic is already dollying in or out, which means the entire camera is moving forward or moving backward, not just side to side, then playing with the scaling can really mess you up. You could create like a fake vertigo. I suggest using very little scaling. You can see in this example here, I do more of a rotate and position because I want more of this foreground piece kind of in the center at the beginning of it. And then later it focuses on the background. I do a little bit of scaling, but not much. You can see a before and after. Just alone, step one, me playing with the scale, position, rotation, and the original shot. Now, I've already went through steps like this for Halo montages and tutorials, but I wanted to focus on Valorant for this one, so this is very familiar steps I've used many times. But step two is adding camera shake. I have tutorials on this, but I'm just going to run it through here. To do this, all we're going to do is add two presets that are default in After Effects. We're going to type in wiggle, and we're going to find wiggle position and wiggle rotation, and we're going to slap those both on top of our clip. Don't worry, it's gonna go a little crazy at first, but there's only a few things we need to control here. So close the big ones and just keep out the speed and the amount. What we're gonna do is go into position, we're gonna change the amount to 10, we're gonna go into rotation, change the amount to 2, and from there, really playing with the speed is how we're gonna get the exact camera shake and how intense we want the camera shake to look. So if I have a fast moving shot, say with intense music and the style is like heavy camera shake because the camera's zoomed in on a character, I would then have my speed position between 2 and 1, somewhere around there. You can ramp it up more depending on if you're doing shakes. Watch my other tutorials for that. And then I would have my rotation between 1 and 0.5, which is very low, but too much really looks fake and you're trying to make it subtle and look realistic. But with a shot like this, which is a lot slower, I'm going to have my position speed at 1, and I'm going to have my, or sorry, I was going to have it at 1, but I changed it to 0.7, and then I'm going to have my rotation speed at 0.5, and if that's still too much, you can bring it down to 0.2, and there I can play it through, and you can see it here, it has a slight camera shake. It's not too much, because like I said, on these longer slow shots, it starts looking fake if you have too much. So that's step 2, adding camera shake. Step 3 is the one that requires the most time, but because right now Valorant doesn't have a theater mode and these are just footage, or this is just cinematics I've captured using their spectator mode, there is no ability to control the depth of field. Now Riot also makes League of Legends and they have a crazy tool that you can add tons of depth of field and change the camera's focal length and basically the lens length as well. But right now there isn't, so we're going to fake the depth of field using After Effects and using blends, blurs, effects. Basically what I'm going to do is right click on the shot we already have, and to keep all the positioning keyframes and our camera keyframe, our camera shake keyframes, there I can speak English, we're going to right click, we're going to go pre-compose, and we're going to leave attributes in this timeline. We're going to go to the new timeline, I'm going to crop it down to basically the length that I'm using for this clip, and our goal here is to create depth of field. So in order to do that, I'm going to duplicate the clip because I'm going to separate the foreground from the background. You could get in more detail and separate foreground, midground, background, but in this shot here, clearly this container is in the foreground and then the rest can all be bundled together in the background for me, making it nice and simple and not too long to make. So what we're going to do is need to mask out the foreground on our top layer so it's just the foreground. And there are two ways to do this. You could use the masking tool. I know it's fairly straightforward and it's a lot easier, but what I personally use, at least in this, is the pen tool because I have more control and a lot of the foreground kind of looks the same color as the background, so I'd rather personally control it. So I like to add the keyframes for the mask at the beginning and at the end. Then in between, I move either 5-frame segments or 10-frame segments, depending on how slow it is. What really helps you with these kind of shots when you're adding depth of field is that you have a nice, smooth camera movement already, like in game for the cinematic, and it's staying consistent on the trajectory. Basically, it's going, it's not wiggling, going all over. That way your keyframes are easy, you're going in the same direction, and you can get it done a lot faster. There's an alarm going off. I don't know if you can hear the police in the background. I'll speed this up so it's a time lapse. You can see I am already keyframing every 5 to 10 frames for the mask so that it stays on the foreground, and I check that I just have the foreground here. Now that I have these two layers, one that is the entire clip and one on top that is the foreground, I look up the effect camera lens blur and I place it on both of the clips, top and bottom. Now I need to find within both of those clips, within the effect camera lens blur, you need to check the box repeat edge pixels. That is very important because there are edges touching the edge of the frame. That makes sense. You don't need to do that if you're doing it on text or something, but because we're using the whole frame, we need to click this box. And now what I did in this shot was I made it rack focus, which means changing the focus or what is in focus from the foreground to the background. You could just keep it where only the foreground's in focus or only the background's in focus, but a rack focus is kind of a nice touch. So I go several frames in and I add a keyframe on the top layer at zero focus because I want, or zero blur, because I want that to be in focus. And at the same timing, down on the bottom layer, I put it to, I believe, 9 on the blur. Here you have to play with it. I find too much blur looks fake, so the more subtle, again, the better and more professional. Then I move a second or two over, and I now change the background that was at 9 to a keyframe of 0. In the foreground, I believe I changed between a 5 to a 9. I don't remember exactly. I'm recording this audio afterward. But then you can see here as I play it, it goes from focus on the foreground to background. And with all the effects combined, it just looks a lot better. You can see before and after. We've just did a few subtle steps to really bring our things to life. And this isn't even adding Twixter or matching it to the beat with this, basically a whip in, a whip out, or any kind of transitions. This is just three simple things you can do to improve your gameplay cinematics using After Effects. Doesn't have to be Valorant. I've done this with a Halo montage, like I've said, or a Halo tutorial many times. But I wanted to run it through for any of my new Valorant fans. This is a great way to make your shots stand out and look better than everyone else's, because a lot of people just slap on an angle and put on some 3D text, but really adding some camera shake and depth of field is what makes these shots beautiful and the maps beautiful. So just add to it. So hopefully that's been helpful. Like I said, I have tutorials on how you can create your own angles, more in depth on how you can do depth of field and camera shake. And if you want to use any of the angles I've already captured, they're all free, just down in the description. You can download them for free. Hope that helps, guys, and let me know what you're looking forward to for another tutorial next week. Thanks, guys, and I'll catch you next time.